Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at the FearDoS virus. This is actually a virus I've been wanting to look at for a very long time, but could never get it to work, but I actually managed to modify it so that we can see what it does. Before we get to the payload, we're just going to take a look at the file itself. So it's just a simple file, just over 2 kilobytes in size, and we will, of course, be able to see file size increases during infections. So let's go ahead and see that happen. So FEAR, we run it, and we have the ominous message, FEAR loaded and ready to infect. Now, any sensible person would probably turn their PC off at this point, but we're going to press ahead and see what it does. Our old friend, graphics.com. As always, 19,742 bytes, but when we run it, FEAR will infect it. Oh, and in this case, it will crash the machine so completely, I have no choice but to hard reset and give you the seek test. So we're back in DOS, and maybe my modification might have caused a few things to get a little bit corrupt. I'm going to run it one more time, and let's try sys.com. Well, did graphics actually get infected? No, it did not, so it failed on infection. Let's try sys. So sys worked. It's normally just around 9,000 and change in size. But we can see here that FEAR has infected it and has grown to 11,255 bytes. So for whatever reason, FEAR will occasionally crash when trying to infect files, and it just so happened to occur when we were trying to infect graphics.com, which is very unfortunate, but sometimes you just have to make do, and you can't infect graphics.com. It's like the old saying goes, you can have your cake, but you can't always infect graphics.com. Let's move right along to the payload. Now, the reason I could never get this to work before is because FEAR waits until the seconds are equal to 59 and then checks to see if a certain register's value is below, I believe, 19. Now, that's 19 in hex, but at any rate, it's a pretty small number, so pretty low odds that you would see this virus activate the way that it does. So I modified it so that if a program is run at 59 seconds, and that value is less than FFFF, it will activate. Which means we're almost guaranteed to see something happen. So let's change our time, and we're gonna run sys, since it's infected. So we are at 39 seconds. Let's do 559, 58, and we're just gonna real quick, and go. So here is what FEAR displays once it activates. Get the full screen pop-up, nice bubbly letter graphics, say FEAR. And I always love this sort of payload. Kind of reminds me of the AIDS DOS virus, if you've seen my video on that or any other videos on it. I'm a sucker for these retro ASCII graphical payloads. And the message is, I am afraid that you have been bitten by the FEAR bug. Just think, you may have passed in on to all of your friends. What fun that will be when it goes off all of their systems. FEAR, copyright 1992, Necrosoft Technologies, developed in the metropolis of sodium chloride in hydrogen dioxide. So the grand city of salt water was the development site of this virus. What do you know? And when you see this, your system is frozen. So there you go, it's starting to beep at me. Does not want me pressing the keyboard because it can no longer accept inputs. You have no choice but to hit Ctrl-Alt-Delete or power off your PC and turn it back on. And despite the very scary message and large graphical payload, it's actually quite harmless. Other than certain infected files crashing, like we saw with graphics, it does not go out of its way to overwrite files or delete information off your hard drive or format your disk. It just displays this if the stars align and you manage to run that program right at 59 seconds and it finds that value is as perfect as it wants it to be. But otherwise, you probably wouldn't notice anything. And that's all I've got to say about fear. Pretty quick video today, but I love payloads like this on DOS viruses, and I hope you enjoyed this video. So let me wrap it up by saying that's about it for the fear DOS virus. Thank you very much for watching. Take care.